Hi, my name is Albert with Mainland Cycle Center, and today we're going to take a look at a 2013 Kawasaki Terex 750 4x4 in the camo. This is a camo LE model. The LE model comes standard with the top, the windshield, and has the pull-out drink holder in the dash. And then the camo that we're looking at here, of course, has the camo finish, but it also has a camo on the wheels, where the regular LEs just have black wheels. The Terex is a really fantastic unit. It's very durable, great performance on them, fantastic brakes, and I'm going to show you a little bit about that rear brake. It has Kawasaki 750cc V-twin, fuel injected, liquid cooled, and this is a twin cylinder motor, and that's important to remember because a lot of our competitors' units are a single cylinder motor. That twin cylinder motor really has fantastic performance. It's really hard to compete a single cylinder against a twin cylinder on these brute forces. They're on these Terexes. I mean, really just fantastic. You got your bucket seats, you've got headrests here on the rollover cage. We've got your gear shifter here, and the new for 2013, this is a linear action as opposed to moving through a gate like the previous year models. But you've got low, high, neutral, and reverse, and basically just move this. It has a real positive feel to it. Actually, when I first saw it, I didn't think I'd like it, but actually I do. This lever is your locking differential. This controls the front differential. So you got selectable two-wheel drive and four-wheel drive. So in two-wheel drive, of course, just the rear wheels are driving. When you engage the four-wheel drive, then, of course, you engage the front wheels. That front end is a limited slip front differential, but you have the ability with the Terex to lock the front differential. So you can pull this back, and that'll lock that differential. But the neat thing about these is it's a variable lock, meaning you can pull it back a little bit, or you can pull it back really hard, meaning if you pull it back just a little bit, it'll allow for a little bit of slippage, but it'll still give you more traction. It'll also probably be a little safer on the drive line than the components if you're in some pretty rough stuff. So sometimes you may want to pull it back a little bit, and then sometimes you may want to pull it back a lot. But anyway, differential lock, variable, that's pretty unique to Kawasaki. We've got a full digital instrumentation. We'll see if we can turn that on. Of course, you've got fuel gauge, speedometer, a clock, odometer, hour meter. I'm trying to see if I can get past this glare. There we go. Odometer tells you if you're in two-wheel drive, four-wheel drive. You know, all that relevant information. That red light that's flashing here is oil pressure warning light. This one is because I don't have the seatbelt on. But it has a neutral light, a reverse light, all of that good stuff. But it's real easy. Got a pull-out drink holder here in the dash. 12-volt power outlet there. Got a good-sized glove box down on the passenger side. Headlight switches here. Sports-style steering wheel. These, of course, as we're talking about, is an automatic transmission. You've just got a gas pedal, a brake pedal, so it drives real easy. Nice little pad here on each side, so you can kind of brace your foot. This is your parking brake here, and then the release is right there on the parking brake. The front hood opens on these. No storage under here, but it gives you access to the radiator, the coolant reservoir, the master cylinder. You know, so for maintenance and cleaning, it's nice that the hood opens and gives you access to all that stuff. Okay. The bed tilts. It's like that. These do have remote reservoir rear shocks on them, so these rear shocks have these little remote reservoirs on them. That gives them just more consistent shock action. We were talking about brakes. These use a hydraulic disc front brake, but in the rear, Kawasaki uses our multi-disc wet rear brake. So the rear brake is right in here. It's built into the same housing that has these gears in it, and so those gears ride in an oil bath, which means they stay very clean. And basically the brake's probably going to last a long time. We've yet to replace a set of rear brakes on these for wear. They do very, very well. But that multi-disc rear brake is fantastic. One of my favorite features on the Terexes. Stainless steel exhaust and mufflers. You remember about those riding out. The air filter is right here between the seats. The motor is there between the seats, so really easy access. I believe these are rated at 500 pounds in the bed. Yeah, 500 pounds in the bed. Of course, the tailgate opens. Got a 2-inch receiver hitch on the back with your dual A-arm, fully independent suspension. These come standard with 26-inch tall tires. I believe they got Maxxis. Yeah, Maxxis tires, 26 inches tall. There's your fuel fill. Regular 87-octane fuel is fine. You do not have to run the premium gas on them. But and then, of course, these come with the top and come with the little half windshield, which is nice. But there you have it. That's a pretty good rundown on the 2013 Kawasaki Terex Camo LE. If you have any questions about this unit, come by and see us. Give me a call. Shoot me an email. If you've never ridden a Terex, you'd like to drive one or at least get for a ride in one, come by and see us. We have a test area here at the dealership. We'd love to take you for a ride and let you drive the Kawasaki Terex, and we'll be happy to do that. So just let us know how we can help on that. All right, so that's a look at the 2013 Kawasaki Terex. Once again, we're Mainland Cycle Center. We're located about 30 minutes south of downtown Houston, just off of I-45 in Lamarck, Texas. Our website is mainlandcyclecenter.com, and our phone number right there is 409-948-4969. Give us a call, shoot us an email, come by and see us. It'd be our pleasure to help. Thank you.